Jawaharlal Nehru was the first Prime Minister as well as the Foreign Minister for Independent India. He was the architect of Indian foreign policy. But unfortunately, no one can deny the fact that his foreign policy miserably failed India. He strongly believed his ideology rather than looking at the reality. For the few mistakes that he made, we are still paying the price. India is still facing the consequences. Number 1, the Kashmiri issue. Pakistan attacked the Kashmir just after 2 months of independence. Instead of fighting back, he ordered a ceasefire, which means he ordered the military to stop fighting and took the case to the United Nations Council. I have no idea how Nehru forgot that the UN Council was a political body, not a court of law. For this one mistake, India paid a huge price. Because it was taken to the UN Council, the Kashmiri issue is still remaining unsolved. For many years, Western countries used the Kashmiri issue to constantly stir up security concerns in the Indian capital. And thanks to Vivek Agnihotri, now we all know what happened to Kashmiri Pandits. Number 2, Indus Water Treaty. Nehru agreed to Indus Water Treaty, which reduced India's share of Indus River water to 20% while Pakistan has 80%. The least he could have agreed is for equal share. This soft approach towards Pakistan left many members of the cabinet unhappy. Even senior members like Mukherjee and Nioji resigned from the cabinet. Number 3, his friendship with China. He trusted China way too much. He never realized that China could be a potential threat to the national security. He underestimated the Chinese threat. Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel had clearly warned him not to trust China, but he neglected his words. This policy approach is called defense by friendship, but Nehru did not realize that China was capable of crushing the friendship for the sake of their own nation. And there was such a contrast between these two countries. Nehru was committed to the Gandhian ideology of peace and non-violence, while China was looking to transform itself from a weak and underdeveloped to a strong and military powerful nation. At least in 1950, when China annexed Tibet, he should have realized that China was not a friend for India. This ignorance eventually led to Sino-Indian War, which ended up as a huge failure for India. Number 4, the nuclear disarmament. In the development of atomic energy and weapons, he laid the foundation for science and technology. But a strong belief in non-violence led him to take up the nuclear disarmament. That means completely eliminating the nuclear weapons, which was again a huge mistake in the history of India. Even after the Sino-Indian War in 1962, his decision was never changed. It was very evident that his foreign policy miserably failed. Even Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, the man who made our constitution, resigned from the cabinet, citing foreign policy failure as a reason. He also said that anyone who has followed the course of a foreign policy could not fail to realize the sudden change that has taken place in their attitude towards us. On 15th August 1947, when we began our life as an independent country, there was no country which wished us ill. Every country in the world was our friend. Today, after 4 years, all our friends have deserted us. We have alienated ourselves. Ambedkar openly criticized his foreign policy at a gathering of Lucknow University students. He stated that the government's foreign policy failed to make India stronger. Why should not India get a permanent seat in the UN Security Council? Why has the Prime Minister not tried for it? India must choose between parliamentary democracy and the communist way of dictatorship and come to a final conclusion. We can't deny the fact that Nehru was a man of inclusiveness. He truly followed the path of Gandhi. But unfortunately, the world doesn't work that way. A foreign minister should be diplomatic enough to handle the world relations. I personally think Nehru could have made a spectacular home minister. His way of peace and non-violence could have made an amazing impact among the people. But to deal with the international politics, one should be way more diplomatic than we can ever expect.